The secret is when you're in that exploratory phase, you need to clearly identify, do they have the problem that you solve? And true good sales professionals, the ones that I've seen grow some of the biggest, you know, 8- and 9-figure businesses that I know personally, they said, look, focus on the one problem that you solve. What's up, Sales Ascender? Hope you're doing well today. I'm so excited to be speaking with you on Wednesday. It's hump day, and we're going to jump right into it. The greatest question came to me this week by Robert O, and he asked, he said, Sean, is asking yes or no a good sales tactic or rule, or can it be improved? And literally the answer to this question is so valuable, right? Like, it depends is the right answer to this question. Well, here's what I mean by this. It depends if you're where you are in the sales conversation, having this conversation. So if you are literally looking for a definitive answer on a point that you're making as a sales professional, then getting a yes or no answer is the right choice. However, if you're in the exploratory set or part of the conversation, then getting to a yes or no is probably the wrong choice. And here's again, like a little bit more of an explanation on this. So during any sales call, there's usually about 7 different areas that you need to kind of check, little boxes you got to check as you're going through the conversation. The first one is just getting bonding and connected and going. Second part is like setting the rules of the sales call. We call setting the rules of the game. We use the analogy game. During the setting the rules of the game, a yes or no question at the end is very powerful. Right. So at the end of the sales call, it was now something like, hey, I'm grateful. G stands for grateful. Game. I'm going to use the analogy. I'll share it with you here. Hey, I'm grateful to be here with you today speaking. A stands for ask. So I'd like to ask you a few questions today to learn more about your business. M stands for me. Hey, I'm sure you're going to have questions for me. And then E stands for at the end of the call, this is kind of how we're going to move forward. Either we're going to go this way or this way. Does that make sense? That's where I'd use a yes or no question. And then as we pass the rules of the game, then we'd move into the discovery or the exploratory part of the sales call or the conversation. And during this part of the sales conversation, asking yes or no questions is typically a bad thing to do. So I'd advise not to do that. Again, the idea is to say, hey, listen, there's a guy named Warren Blair, and he came out with this PDF of, it's called One Sentence Persuasion. You can look it up. Just Google in Warren Blair, One Sentence Persuasion. There's a PDF that'll pop up. Read that document. It's 13 pages long. Literally, it'll talk all the way through psychology. And what I'm sharing is that in it, he shares kind of 5 principles. The first one is encouraging dreams of your prospects. So like when you're in that pain conversation, what you want to do is take that encouraging the dreams part and say, hey, listen, like, tell me about your business. Where are you trying to take it? Where are you trying to go? Or what are you trying to do with your life right now? Where are you trying to go? You're encouraging their dreams, but you want them to share their dreams with you. So that's not a yes, no question. That's like, yo, tell me where you're trying to go. And then right after they share that and they're all high and feeling good about it, turn the conversation around and say, tell me, what's the biggest speed bump that you've encountered trying to get to the destination that you're going to? And then they're going to say this. Whatever that is, again, that's not a yes or no question. This is the exploratory part of the sales conversation. And literally now you can dive in deep on talking about the speed bump and understanding the problem that they have. And then you match as a sales professional, like, hey, does my solution solve the problem? Because if your solution doesn't solve the problem, you should never go past that part into a selling conversation. You should literally stop the conversation from getting any more salesy or whatever, right? So the secret is when you're in that exploratory phase, you need to clearly identify, do they have the problem that you solve? And true good sales professionals, the ones that I've seen grow some of the biggest, you know, 8- and 9-figure businesses that I know personally, they said, look, focus on the one problem that you solve. So great advice. So going back to this question, yes or no questions are great in certain parts of the selling conversation. However, when you're getting into the exploratory and discovery part of the conversation, you should never be asking a yes or no question. And then after we pass that part, we get into some of the budget or the buying decision questions. Those ones should probably be yes or no. And so I do use yes or no's, but I also use the, you know, the open-ended questions as well quite a bit in certain areas of my selling conversation. And typically when you marry that nice blend, typically what I would say is for every yes or no question in a sales conversation, like let's say there's maybe five of them you ask, you should probably ask 15 to 20 open-ended questions. So if there's a ratio there, that'd probably be where I would sit. I haven't actually looked at those numbers, so don't quote me on that. But yeah, just connect with people and see if you can solve their problem by not asking yes or no questions in the discovery. And for the rest of the time, when you need a definitive answer, using this tactic is a great move. So happy Wednesday to you guys. I hope that answers your question. And man, that was a great question, Robert. Thank you so much for asking. If you have a sales question, drop a comment below. Let me know what it is. I'd be happy to answer it on a high ticket tune-up for you to make sure that you get served at the highest level, because where we are sales ascenders, always revenue, always relevant. Let's prospect, let's ascend, go fight, win. And by the way, if you're an entrepreneur serving other businesses and you're struggling to consistently put qualified opportunity on a sales calendar, personally message me, because I would love to have that conversation with you. I'm an expert at solving that problem. That's the one problem that I'm really, really good at. So let's talk about it. With that said, I love your face. Have a wonderful Wednesday, and I'll see you tomorrow.